humanity has always sought to answer important questions. Who is stronger, Arnold Schwarzenegger or Sylvester Stallone? Who is cooler, Mario or Sony? Who steals more user data? Which one is better, iOS or Android? Let me prove what one platform is superior in emulation. Android can run iOS applications now. Are we now living a Steve Jobs emulation dream?
Wouldn't it be great if we could play some of those titles too? Well, it is software that turns your Mac into a Sony PlayStation.
So, let me tell you a story about software which turns your Android into an Apple's iPhone. Our story begins with a brilliant person known as Hikari no Yumi, a magical girl on the internet. In 2022, she decided to write a full-blown iOS emulator just to play Super Monkey Ball iOS. The origins of this project and Hikari's motivations were covered in greater detail by Stop Skeletons from Fighting video and a post in Hikari's blog. For the context of this video, Touch HLE is an open-source high-level emulator for iOS 2 apps, written in Rust.
Rust Foundation.
Open up!
Sorry, I used the wrong logo. As of version 0.1.2, released in early March of this year, it's capable of running three games: Super Monkey Ball, Crash Bandicoot, Nitro Kart 3D, and Touch and Go. But wait, what's your deal here? Touch HLE is already capable of running iOS applications. Well, let's carefully read readme of the project as of March 2023. It will be desirable to eventually support Android. This is probably not too much work. Completely hooked by this, I started to work on the Android port. And oh gosh, it was far from not too much work. I don't know much about Rust, and quick googling reveals what Rust is: low-level programming language which claims to be safer than C or C++ by implementing a borrow checker. Rephrasing an old joke, this means that while in C you have a total freedom to shoot yourself in the foot, in Rust you could not, because your foot was already borrowed. I'm not an Android expert either, but I'm sure that if you want to use anything but Java, you are in a big trouble. Luckily enough, Touch HLE is already using SDL under the hood, which should simplify things greatly. Good old SDL. If I received a $1 for each video where I priced SDL, I will have $3 by now. After a few days of work, I finally have the first working Android build. And... as you can see, music, sounds and touch controls do work, but OpenGL image rendering is not working at all.
3 days later.
I'm still stuck, which means there is only one last resort. Reading OpenGL docs. OpenGL ES full specification version 1.1 contains long names, cryptic diagrams, Greek letters. It's like a very nerdy version of the Dead Sea Scrolls. After meditating over OpenGL ES specs for hours, I stumbled upon the gel copy text image 2D function, which seems to be exactly what I need. I quickly recompiled the code and... it works! Finally! The image itself is not in the right place, but this is trivially fixable with hard coding. As you may notice, accelerometer input is not yet implemented, so the only way to play is by using a game controller. Here I'm using an Xbox 360 wireless controller connected to the LG Nexus 5X. Now it's time to do a tweet and let Hikari know what Touch HLE has been ported to Android. The next steps are to finish the POC phase, clean it up and do a proper PR to the main repo. Considering the size of pull request, it's not surprising what code review took about a month to complete. Meanwhile, some people got impatient about it, resulting in an article on 9to5Mac. Well, I don't know about you, but I am still very excited. And thanks to Hikari's efforts, the PR was finally merged on May 6. So the next Touch HLE release should officially support Android. It's great, but can it run Doom? Well, first, let's answer a simpler question. Can it run Wolfenstein 3D? Wolfenstein 3D for iOS was released on March 25 of 2009, and it was unique in several ways. It was the first ID Software game to be ported to the iOS platform. Also, it was open sourced under GPL. Last but not least, it was ported to iPhone by John Carmack himself. Now it's my turn to port Wolf 3D to a new platform. The first few hours of porting a new game are very frustrating. You try to run the game, it crashes on unimplemented function. You implement it, recompile, and then it crashes again on another function. It seems like this game should be called instead Dump, it crashed in the loop. Anyway, after few days of trials and errors, I finally have a working menu. But when I try to start a new game, it crashes. A few more hours of tinkering, and finally it's working. However, there is still one more issue. The game crashes if you get shot. So, to me, this is not a game issue, it's skill issue. I even considered leaving it unfixed, effectively introducing a new level of game difficulty. I also fixed the music and sounds, completing a playable desktop version. Once we have the desktop version working, it's time to test the Android build as well. And... have you ever been in a disco dungeon? There is a bug, not inside Touch HLE, but in the source code of the Wolf 3D iOS. Let's take a look at the iPhone frame function of the version 1.0, which is used, among other things, to fill the screen with red when the player dies. An array of blend color values is created at the beginning, filled with values when the player dies, and a box is drawn full screen if the alpha value of the color is not 0. Do you see the problem? Correct. An uninitialized array in C can be filled with garbage. This bug was fixed in version 2.1. I wanted to make version 1.0 to work. The trivial, yet hacky solution is to recompile it from sources with the fix implemented. Now everything is working well on Android, however, there is still a few limitations. For example, multi-touch is not yet implemented. So you should choose wisely, move or shoot. Still, it's very playable, and I can confirm what it's possible to completely finish the first episode of Wolf 3D iOS on Android using this setup. Let's go back to porting the iOS Doom, which originally was released on October 30 of 2009. According to John himself, while Wolfenstein 3D was a quickie project, Doom requires a much more serious effort. I could not agree more. As usual, we start by making a game menu work. In this case, the background of menu is animated, which requires a few iterations to get it working correctly. Now we can finally start the game. And... it's not crashing, the music still plays, but the image is completely frozen. It seems like demons from hell have invaded not only Mars, but also the Touch HLE graphics pipeline. The issue is actually very easy. Semi-cooperative threading model is prone to deadlocks when host-to-guest calls stuck. Easy, right? Okay, okay, let me explain. Doom for iOS is actually using two threads to run the game, a main thread and a game thread, what are synchronized via POSIX semaphores. This can be effectively result in a deadlock if a called thread has a dependency on the execution of the initial one. If it's less clear for you after my explanation, don't worry. The bottom line is, unfortunately, this is one of Touch HLE's most fundamental design limitations, and fixing it won't be easy. Unless we change the source code of iOS Doom to use a single thread. As dumb as it sounds, the fusion of two threads actually works and requires only 7 lines of changes in the initial code base. Now Touch HLE can run Doom. And... I proudly present to you Doom Homeless Edition, because there are no floors or ceilings. More seriously, an error occurs during the execution of the libtest library, which is responsible for tessellation. After fixing the return value of the setJump function in Touch HLE, everything is working as expected. Surprisingly enough, the Android version works without any modifications. And I can confirm what it's possible to finish the first episode. It took me more than 1 hour, but that's because of testing, right, testing. Okay, are we finished now? Well, there is one more thing. This is local Doom iOS multiplayer running between an iPhone 3GS and the Touch HLE on a MacBook Pro M1. This is possible because both macOS and iOS support the same API for DNS service discovery, which, unfortunately, does not work out of the box on Android. Few final thoughts and disclaimers. As usual, all of the source code is available on my GitHub. You can see the status of the different branches on the screen. If you want to try the Android version for yourself, you should wait for an official release or compile it from the sources. In any case, please don't ask me or Hikari for an APK to download. Consider joining the read-only Discord server to be notified about the Touch HLE releases. Another important disclaimer. Please only use Touch HLE to emulate software you legally own. Even if you do so, please don't open issues about apps that are not yet included in the official compatibility list. Okay, if you watched this far, thank you, really. Consider liking this video, writing a comment and subscribing to the channel if you want more content like this. Also, please follow me on the Twitter, as I try to post regular progress updates about the projects I'm currently working on. Don't worry, this won't consume all of your Twitter quotas. Big thanks goes to Hikari Noyumi, not only for creating such a cool project, but also for her help with Touch HLE development issues. consider following her on Twitter and other social media platforms. I should also mention Fabien Sanglar's website, as his blog posts about Wolfenstein 3D and Doom were really helpful. Last but not least, I want to say thank you to my wife, as she was really supportive during the work on this project, and also she said what if I will not thank her properly, she will kill. Anyway, that's all for today. Bye!